The devotees, we follow the religious principle. Like any Indian family, they can say, even I remember my mother. My mother, in my entire career, since the I have got the remembrance, host jab se aaya, I have never seen my mother utter my father's name in her mouth. No. Like, suppose my father's name is Suri Narayan. She will say Bhaskara, she will say Ravi, but will never say Surya. So, this is the culture. No. And there is a reason behind this. Of course, for some official and legal documents, she may write. The officer may ask her, what is your pati's husband's name? She will write. But she will never utter the name of the husband in her mouth. Similarly, the chaste lady, in the same way, the chaste disciple, he or she will never utter the name of the spiritual master openly, publicly, anywhere and everywhere. She will say, my spiritual master say, my Guru Maharaj say, or the title say, just like with the Srila Prabhupada, like that. But this is why, the reason is that, when a lady utters the name of her husband anywhere and everywhere, the duration of the life of her husband reduces. In the same way, this is not the etiquette that a chaste disciple or lady always utter the name of the spiritual master. Do you know who is my spiritual master? Everyone knows it. And always tells the name of the lady. No need. Just Guru Maharaj says, spiritual master says, like that they say. So this is the common attitude. But it's very hard to say nowadays. If we say all these things in 2019, there may be a great revolt or against. So nowadays we see the ladies, they utter their husband's name like anything. One time I saw one family came to the temple and she was calling her husband by name in such a way that as if he is not the husband, he is her nokar. Hey Ramesh, idhar. Like that. She asked like that. Uttering the name and in asking, calling in such a way, even if that also, as if he is the servant. So, at least we, the devotees, we hear the shastras, there are many devotees in our ISKCON community, congregation devotees, the disciples of Srila Prabhupada, many, even other Gurus Maharaj disciples, they follow the religious principle very strictly. Whether they are Western body or Indian body, but they just stick to the follow of religious path. They are exemplary families, exemplary matas and exemplary prabhus also.